In this video, I will explain how the banking system in the economy creates credit out of the deposits maintained in the system. Firstly, credit creation is simply it is the process of creating loans. It is the process of creating loans and advances out of the deposits maintained in the banking system by the public. For example, the public makes a deposit of $100 in the banking system, and the system creates loans and advances to other customers out of the $100. It is called deposit creation or credit creation. Let us explain how the banking system can create credit out of the deposit maintained. Suppose that in the banking system, the cash reserve ratio is 10%. What it means is that out of any $100 deposited in the banking system, the commercial banks, they maintain $10 of cash reserves in the central bank, and they can use the rest $90 only. So we next assume that the banks, they do not want to hold cash reserve in excess, means they do not want any dollar out of this 90 to keep with themselves. They want to lend all the $90. And thirdly, we assume that the public also do not want to hold cash balances. As soon as they get cash balances, they immediately deposit the balance in the bank. So now let us take an example. Suppose that the first individual, he makes a deposit of $100 in a bank called Bank A. So now the Bank A's balance sheet will be affected like below. So this is Bank A's balance sheet, this asset side and liability side. On the liability side, the deposits of the bank will go up by $100. So deposit is a liability for the bank, and it will go up by $100, and its cash reserve will go up by $100. Bank A will divide this $100 into two items. So since the cash reserve ratio is 10%, it will maintain a CRR of $10 in the central bank, and it will extend a credit of $90. So the first bank, Bank A, will lend all the $90 to an individual, suppose individual B. So now individual B, he can spend the $90 from his loan account. Suppose that he withdraws all the $90 and he pays the $90 to individual third. So now individual third can make a deposit of $90 with the same bank, I mean Bank A, or he can make a deposit with any other bank. Let us assume that he deposits the $90 in Bank B. Now Bank B's balance sheet will be affected as below. Bank B's liability will go up by $90, and Bank B's cash reserve will go up by $90. Again, assuming that the cash reserve ratio is cash reserve ratio is 10%, Bank B will divide the $90 into two items. It will maintain a cash reserve ratio, a cash reserve of $9 in the central bank, and it will extend loan of the rest, that is $81. So suppose that Bank B extends a loan of $81 to any individual, say individual 4. So now individual 4 can withdraw the $81 from his loan account, and he can deposit the amount anywhere in any bank. Suppose that he deposits the money in bank C. Now, as bank C's balance sheet will be affected like this. Its liability will go up by $81 and its cash reserve will go up by $81. And bank C, following the same line of reasoning, it maintains a 10% cash reserve ratio and it lends all the remaining money balances. So it will give a loan of $72.9 to an individual, let's say individual 6. So this process continues until the deposit amount reduces to 0. And we can summarize the process in a table. So this is bank A, initial deposit of $100. It divides into 90 and 10. And this 10 goes to Central Bank. And this $90 is deposited in bank B. Again, $9 goes to Central Bank. And 81 goes in the form of credit. And this 81 is deposited in bank C. Again, 8.1 goes to Central Bank. And this process continues until the sum of the required reserves goes up to 100, or the sum of the total credit created reaches 1,000. So this amount 1,000 can be calculated by using a formula which we call a credit multiplier or deposit multiplier, which says that the deposit creation or credit creation, in the economy will be equals to the initial deposit divided by the cash reserve ratio. So in this example, the change in credit creation or the extra credit creation will be equal to the extra deposit made initially in the banking system, which is $100 divided by the cash reserve ratio, which is 0.1. So now this becomes $1,000. So basically, we can calculate the total credit that can be created in the banking system by using this deposit multiplier formula. So in this formula, the value of 1 over R is called deposit multiplier, or it is also called credit multiplier. It says that simply if the initial deposit is $100, credit creation will be 1 over R times $100. So 1 over R here is 1 over 0.1, which is 10. So the credit creation will be 10 times of the original deposit in this case. So now let us assume if R equals to 20%, what will happen? So this is 1 over R, which is 1 over 0.2, which is 5. So if the cash reserve ratio were 5%, it will further go up to 20. So this 1 by R is called the credit multiplier. Now, how the central bank can control the volume of credit creation in the economy can be analyzed with the credit creation multiplier. So it says that the change in credit creation will be equal to 1 over R times change in deposit. So this has been derived from the formula that I just wrote, which is credit equals to 1 by R times deposit. So I just take change on both sides. So this becomes change in credit creation equals to 1 over r times change in deposit. So in this formula, the central bank can control the value of r in order to control the volume of credit. So we can experiment r being 10%, r being 20%, r being 5%, and suppose that the initial deposit or change in deposit or increase in deposit is $100. So now if r is 10%, what will be the change in credit? Change in credit creation is 1 over 0.1 times 100. So this is $1,000. Now what happens to the credit creation when r is 20%? So this is 1 upon 0.2 times 100. So this is 5 times 100 is 500. Now what happens when r is 0.05? So in this case, change in credit creation equals to 1 upon 0.05 into 100, and this will be $2,000. So this equals to $2,000. So by changing the value of R, the central bank can reduce the possible amount of credit creation in the economy, or it can increase the total credit creation power. So this story seems very much interesting, but it has some limitations. The first limitation for the multiplier principle to work is that the banking system, they do not want to keep excess reserves besides the cash reserve ratio. So in our example, out of the $100 deposit, the bank divides $10 in the form of cash reserve ratio and it lends $90. So for example, suppose that it cannot lend $90 but keeps excess reserve of $20. So in this case, the bank's lending will be simply $70 only. So in this case, the credit creation will shrink somehow. The next limitation is that for this multiplier process to work, there should be no tendency of the public to hold cash balances. So for example, in the first round, when the bank divides $100 as 10 cash reserves and $90 in loan. Suppose the bank lends $90 to some individual, say individual 7, but individual 7 holds a cash balance of $90. So if the individual 7 holds a cash balance of $90, now the credit creation process stops here because this $90 does not return to the banking system. So for this process to work, individuals should not be willing to hold a cash balance. The third one is that there should be favorable environment for bank lending. I mean, there should be no recession. If there is a recession, the individuals will not take any loans from the banking system and the credit creation process will shrink, or it can even stop. So thank you for watching my video, and please like and share this video and subscribe my channel.